हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज सविता पवार. वेलकम टू माय चैनल गेट द मैथ. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ द वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 6B ऑफ लेसन 6 परसेंटेज. इन द अबव आई लिंक आई हैव शेयर्ड द वीडियो ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 6A. इफ यू हैव नॉट गॉन थ्रू इट, प्लीज गो थ्रू इट. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 6B. 36% of students in the school are girls. If the number of the boys are 1440, find the total strength of the school. So we don't know the total strength of the school, which is to be found out. So let that be x here. Number of boys has been given 1440. Percentage of the girls has been given 36. See, both these units are different here. It is number of boys has been given and the percentage given is the girls. So you need to find the percentage of the boys in the school. So subtract 36 from 100 since it is a percentage value. So 100 minus 36 is 64%. Why we have to find the percentage of boys? Because we have to equate the value on left hand side. The whatever the value we are taking, whatever its unit is, the same thing should be on the right hand side of the equal to. Then only we can equate the equation. Okay? Then only we can equate those values. So since the number of boys has been given, so the percentage should also be in the of the number of boys. So therefore 64% of x equal to 1440. So percentage means upon 100, of means multiply, x equal to 1440. So that gives here, you want to find the value of x, so this fraction goes to the other side and get its inverse. So 1440 multiply by 100 divided by 64, on cancellation you get the answer as here. This becomes 4 1s are 4 6 are 24 and this is 4 25s are 4 4s are 16. This will be 4 3s are 4 6s are and 0. 4 1s are 4 9s are 0. So this is 90 into 25, that gives you 2250. These are the total strength of the school. So total strength of the school is x equal to 2250. So this way you have to solve it. Second is, Geeta saves 18% of the monthly salary. If she spends 10 250 per month, what is her salary? So we don't know her monthly salary, let that be x. Now the amount given is of spending, that Geeta spends 10,250 rupees, and the percentage has been given of savings, that she saves 18%. Now this is different, this is spending and this is savings. So we need to find the percentage of spending here, that becomes 100 minus 18 is 82. Then only we can equate it with this one. So 82% of x equal to 10,250. Okay, so the next step will be 82 by 100 into x equal to 10,250. Find the value of x here. Therefore, x will become 10,250 multiplied by 100 by 82. Okay, so do the cancellation here. 2 4s are 1s are, okay, 2 5s are 0 and 41 1s are, and this will be 41 250s are. So the answer is 250 multiplied by 50, so that is 12500. Okay, so we need to find her monthly salary. So her monthly salary is, so her monthly salary x equal to 12500 rupees. Okay, so one thing you must always remember, while doing the equation, while writing the equation, the units on the LHS should be equal to the units on the RHS. If you are finding for savings here, the amount should be for saving. If the percentage is for spending, then the amount should also be for spending here. In an examination, a student has to secure 40% marks of to pass. Rahul gets 178 marks and fails by 32. What are the maximum marks? So the paper was of how much maximum marks, that we don't know. So let that be X marks. Rahul scores 178 but fails by 32. So the passing marks will be, add these two things, that will be 210 are the passing marks. Okay. And the passing percentage has been given as 40%. So 40% of 200 of X equal to 210. That is, if you do 40% of this total, the passing marks will be 210. So find the value of X now, that will be your total marks. So X equal to 210 multiplied by 100 by 40. So 00 cancel and 4 ones are 425. So it is 21 multiplied by 25. So that gives you 525 marks. Okay, so the sentence was, the maximum marks are, the maximum marks were X equal to 525. Fourth one is, 8% of the students in school remained absent on a day. If 1633 attended the school, that means this much were present in the school, then how many remain absent? So the number of students present in the school were 1633. So see here, where the students present number is given as 1633, but the percentage has been given for the absent, that was 8%. So you need to find the students present, percentage of the students present, that it becomes 100 minus 8 equal to 92%. So how many students were absent, number of the students absent on that day we have to find, and for that first we need to find the total number of students. So let the total number of students be X here. So always percentage of with the total we have to take. Okay, so 92% of the present students of the total will be equal to the number of present students of the school, that is 1633. So 92% of X, this is the percentage of the students present, and these are the number of the students present. So both are of present here, so we can equate that now. So 92 upon 100 X equal to this, so X equal to 1633 multiplied by 100 by 92. So if you solve this, you get the answer here as 1775. So the total number of students are, total number of students, that is X here, is 1775. But we need to find the number of absent students. So number of students absent, number of students absent. So you can subtract present students from the total one, that is 1775 minus 1633, that gives you 142. So 142 students were absent in the school. Next question is, on increasing the price of an article by 14%, it becomes 1995. What is the original price? So if you buy an article whose original price we don't know, let it be X here. Now the price has been increased by 14%. So now the increased price becomes here 1 plus. I have shown in the video of 6A. So how we have to write the increased price? I have written all the formulas. So that's why please go through the introduction video. This is increased price becomes 1 plus 14% of X. That becomes 114 X upon 100 rupees. Now the increased price in the amount, it becomes as 1995. So this is the increased price in percentage, and this is the increased price in the amount. So that both should be equal. So for that, we can find the value of X here. So X becomes 1995 multiplied by 100 upon 114. Okay, so that comes out to be 1750 rupees. So the original price was, the original price of the article that was x equal to 1750 rupees. Okay. And it was increased by 14%, then it became 1995. The next one here is on decreasing, similar to question number 5, this sixth question is on decreasing the price of the article by 6%, it becomes 1551. So what is the original price? So let the original price be X, decreasing price is 6%. So decrease means you have to subtract it here. 1 minus 6% of X, that becomes 6 upon 100, you can write here 1 minus 6 upon 100, then take the LCM and solve. So 100 minus 6 becomes 94 x upon 100 rupees. And the decrease price in the amount it is given in the question as 1551. So we can equate these two, percentage, decrease percentage and decrease amount. So therefore x equal to 1551 multiplied by 100 by 94. So that gives you 1650 rupees. Okay. So this way, by doing a simple calculation, you can solve the word problems. Just only you have to remember the value on the LHS should be the same as the value on the RHS. Therefore, the original price of an article X equal to 1650 rupees. Seventh question is, Renu reduced her weight by 15%. If now she weighs 52.7 kg, what was her earlier weight? So we don't know her earlier weight, it will let be X. So percentage of her reduced weight was 15%. So at present, what is her weight, we don't know. So that let be 100 minus 15, that is 85%. So her weight at present is now 52.7 kg. So this is present percentage of weight and this is present weight in kg. So we will equate it now. 85 by 100 of this multiply, no need to write multiply, it is simply known, and this is 7 by 10. Okay, so find the value for X. Now X is 527 upon 10 multiply by 100 and this is 85. So on doing the cancellation, you get the answer as 62 kg. So her earlier weight was, that is Renu's earlier weight was X equal to 62 kg. Okay. Here in this question 8-1, two candidates contested in an election. One of them secured 58% votes and won the election by a margin of 2560 votes. How many votes were polled in all? So we need to find the total number of votes polled, let that be X votes. Percentage of the votes won by the winning candidate, that is given as 58% in the question. So find the percentage of the votes received by the losing candidate, so that becomes 100 minus 58 is 42%. Now the difference in the votes by which the winning candidate has won the election, it is given as 2560. The winning candidate has won by 2560 than the losing candidate. So difference in their votes equal to 2560. So percentage of difference in their votes becomes 58x upon 100 minus 42x upon 100 equal to 2560. Now as the numerator, as the denominator is same, you can directly subtract the numerator. So you get the answer here as 16x by 100 equal to 2560. So x equal to 2560 multiplied by 100 upon 16. So do the cancellation, 16 ones are 16, 16s are and the 0. So it is 16000, that is 16,000 votes. So the total votes polled were, the total votes polled were x equal to 16,000 votes. Ninth is, this is an examination, we want to find the aggregate percentage here. So in our examination, Preeti scored 60 out of 75 in science. Now different subjects have been given and their total marks are not out of 100. So if we want to find the percentage, we need to find out of 100 for that. So this is out of 75 for science, she scored 60. Then out of 100 in maths, she scored 84. Out of 50 in Hindi, she scored 36. And out of 45 in English, she scored 30. So for each and every subject, we need to find the percentage. So for first, we will find for science here. So out of 75, she scored 60. So out of 100, how much? That will be your 80%. Then out of, for maths, out of 100, it was 84% already given. Then for Hindi, out of 50, she scored 36. So out of 100 will be 72%. Then for English, out of 45, she scored 30. So out of 100 will be how much? That is coming 200 by 3. So that means 63.666. It will go on. So write in the approximate form, 66.67%. Okay. Now answer the following questions. First one is, in which subject her performance was worst? So in which subject she scored the least marks? That was English. Second one is, in which subject her performance is the best? The one which scored highest, that was the maths. Second answer is maths. And her aggregate percentage. So third question is to find her aggregate percentage. So there are four subjects. Add the percentage of the four and divide it by four. So that comes your aggregate percentage. Okay. Tenth question is, the price of an article is increased by 25%. By how much percent must this new value be decreased to restore its former value? Now the original price of the article was X rupees. First they increase the price by 25%. So the price is increased. So this becomes your increased price. So this is increased price equal to 1 plus 25% of x, that is 125x upon 100. On cancellation you get 5x by 4. Now they want to again restore the former value, the first value. So for that we need to subtract this from the total. So that is 5x upon 4 minus x, that gives you x. On taking the LCM of here, it will be 1 here, and take the LCM. So 5x minus 4x upon 4, that becomes x by 4 rupees. And now this is the amount that we want, that we should must reduce from this one so as to get the same amount here. So what will be the percentage then? The percentage reduction will be required reduction amount, this one, upon the increased salary multiplied by 100%. So required reduction amount is x by 4. Increased salary, or sorry, increased price will be, so increased price, that will be 5x by 4 multiplied by 100. Now you can take the inverse of this 5x by 4, it becomes 4 upon 5x. On cancelling 4, 4 and x, x and 5 ones are 5, 20 is a, it becomes 20%. So the percentage reduction required for that article to restore the former value is 20%. So that's all for now. In the next video, some more questions I will be going to solving for exercise 6B. If you have any query, you can ask me in the comment box. Do like, share and subscribe my channel, Get the Math.